Thank you, everyone. Let's all take a seat because the show is about to begin.
And now, the story of the first Friendsgiving. Long, long ago, in 2005, in the land of Brooklyn, a pioneer named Aspen came to live by his belief that he should be a singer-songwriter.
I am an artist. Sup, dogs?
Aspen could not go home for Thanksgiving because he didn't want to.
Sorry, Mom. I'm really slammed. See you at Christmas. Oh, no. My favorite bars are closed. I know what I'll do. I'll make a new holiday that takes place on Thanksgiving. I'll call it Friendsgiving.
Aspen put forth the call far and wide that all might come to Friendsgiving.
Like, give me a heads up how many total.
Tight.
Sounds cool.
Sunglasses emoji. All the friends brought something to share. And this is what they brought.
I am beer.
I am one raw potatoes. That's Thanksgiving, right?
I'm a weird rice thing brought by a vegan. There's plenty of me for everyone.
Gross!
This is going great. Now it's time to put the turkey in the oven.
I am Aspen's oven. I've never been used and I've always...
Been...
Broken.
Broken.
Oh no, my oven is broken. And there's not enough food. And I only have one chair. What will I do?
And in Aspen's darkest hour, a Friendsgiving miracle did occur.
I'm a native Brooklyn drug dealer. I have drugs for sale.
Yay, drugs!
And so everyone ate and drank and smoked a little pot because they didn't have to worry about their parents.
Everyone's sure Grace and Jeff went home together
because of me!
And that's the story why we celebrate Friendsgiving every year until we grow up.
That's cultural appropriation.
Hi, it's Zach from College Humor. Thanks for watching. You can click here to subscribe, or you can click over here for something else fun. You can also click here if you want to feed me clicks. I like them. Mmm, clicks.